film me all night, are you, mate? Yeah, apparently he's going to put this up on Twitter. I promise to mind my P's and Q's. Yeah, so for those who don't know, for my sins, having finished up being president of the RACI, I said, yeah, I'll run the Centenary Congress, which is now, the reason I put this website up, only 67 days away. It's getting close. So much of the organisation has been completed at a technical level. Last week I had to be a bit of a grumpy old man and read the riot act to some parts of the RACI that were way overdue in getting their abstracts sorted out. I put out a threat and said, if it isn't all done by close of business last Friday, I'll make the decisions, and I don't care whether a PhD student gives a talk and a professor gives a poster, that will be the consequence of not getting your things done on time. And yesterday morning I found that everyone, I know students got talks, yeah, but that was not me, because everyone got their abstracts sorted out, so my grumpy old man routine was sorted. It was actually a serious deal because there are, I'm going to read some stats to you in a moment. There are a number of people that have not yet registered for the Congress because they don't yet, or have not as of last week, known the outcome of their abstract submission. And that's less of an issue domestically, but we're getting down to the wire for people from overseas who need visas and so forth. So it's beyond a matter. It's one of these tensions in the RACI being a volunteer organisation where volunteers say, oh yeah, I'll do that, and then they don't meet the timelines. Well, this Congress, last November when I was at the Assembly meeting in Melbourne, I pointed out that depending upon how the Congress goes, we could make $500,000 surplus, or we could lose close to $2 million, which is, in round figures, the total asset base of the RACI. So I could bankrupt the RACI and never have the second 100 years. We won't be doing that now, which I'll talk about briefly. So a lot of detail now is on the Congress webpage. If I encourage you to go and have a look at it, racicongress.com. And the reason I put this page up is I wanted to have the day countdown to make people realise it's getting close, because that is a relatively small number. It's only two months away. But there's a lot of detail now. Simon, I don't know how to drive your computer. You've taken it
for you.
Yeah, you drive. If you look under speakers, if you go and have a look, if you're interested, under all of the different programs, if we go to the RACI part, because this is an RACI meeting, all of the divisions, you'll see details of all the headline speakers. Pick one, anyone, analytical chemistry. Jesus, yeah, you're biased, aren't you? Right, and you scroll down and you can see who all the keynote headline speakers are for their various programs. Justin Gooding, God. Yeah, you are filming this, I keep forgetting. I've got to be careful, Justin will have it on record now that I'm sorry, buddy. When he sees it. A lot of detail there that you can now see in terms of the technical program. We're doing this meeting in partnership with seven other organisations, including the RACI part of the meeting. This Centenary Congress has seven other organisations: the Asian Coordination Chemistry Congress, the Asian, that's the Asian Chemistry Congress. Put it back. It's a program. That's part of the RACI effectively, the Coordination Chemistry Conference, a medicinal, very small scale drug design conference. AMEX is medicinal chemistry. Carbon is World Carbon Congress. Chemica, our colleagues from industrial chemistry, run the annual Chemica meeting with us. As part of that program, Alan Finkel, Australia's chief scientist, is speaking at we're going to call it a Shark Tank, based upon the Channel 10 program, but it turns out that to do that violates all sorts of copyright law and whatever, so now it's called a Sharp Brain. That's it. It used to be Shark Tank, now it's Sharp Brain, to avoid getting sued out of existence. And you can see somewhere in there, I think Alan Finkel's in the mix. Oh, maybe I got it wrong. Oh, here he is. No, that's Robin Batterhand. You can see a wide range of highly eminent Australians, chemists. There you go. Yes, there's all sorts of good things in there. So I encourage you to go and have a look. It's technically, it's pretty much sorted out. Now, to give you some numbers, To give you an idea of the size and scale of this meeting, typically when the RACI runs a congress or a national convention or whatever, there are between 1,000 and 1,500 people at most. To celebrate our 100 years, we're doing something bigger than the RACI has ever done before, which is why last November I thought there's a good chance if we don't get this worked out, we could bankrupt the RACI. In our most optimistic view of the world, looking at all of those partners that I pointed out together with the RACI, we were designing the most optimistic rose-coloured worldview, 3,800 delegates. It turns out that when abstracts closed, a little while ago now, a month, 6 weeks ago, we received a total of 3,305 abstracts. So we got very, very close to our target. Registrations are still coming in because a significant number of people have only in the last day or two, including today, found out, was it today or yesterday? Yesterday? Today, today. Yes, because it's actually analytical, it was finalised yesterday rather than Friday, that's okay. There are a number of people who have only just received notification of the acceptance of their abstract and whether it's a talk or a poster or whatever. But we're currently looking at a total of, as of yesterday, 15th of May,
the evening goes
6:23.
Sorry, 2,511 registered delegates. We will get, which is bigger than anything the RACI has done before, so it's exciting. It turns out about somewhere between 150 and 200 of those people receive complimentary registrations because they are the speakers of the ilk that Simon was showing earlier when he was driving the website. One of the ways this conference has been organised is that I'll pick analytical because Simon had it before. If the analytical division of the RACI is running a program over 5 days, then there was a formula run to say they get X number of complimentary registrations to invite speakers in and stuff like that. So that figure of just over 2,500 includes the complimentaries. And so we are a smidge, with 67 days to go, we are a smidge under the break-even point of the Congress. So one of the bits of news I thought I'd tell you now is that the Centenary Congress of the RACI is not going to bankrupt the RACI.
So you're not
going
to go to prison?
I'm not going to prison, but I think they would have come and take my Leighton Medal back and said we're going to melt it down to pay some of the bills. So, which is really good news, and I'm utterly confident that we're going to be in surplus territory in the not too distant future. If we had 3,800 people, the back of the envelope budgeting is we would have had close to $1 million surplus. Because once you get the break-even point, every delegate after that is pure icing on the cake. And now the other thing that's good for us in terms of, I could stand here and say it was outstanding Congress design, but I'd call it more serendipity. We designed from the outset 40% of paid delegates being students or retirees at the concessional rate. And as of yesterday, in round figures, 40% of our registrations are students or retirees. So we're right on target, which is really good. Everything's panning out. So things are really looking good. We get close to that. We'll never get 3,305 people because a significant number of those have submitted multiple abstracts. I'll probably get a talk here and a poster there or something. But I expect that we're going to be up at about 2,800 or 2,900 people if we're lucky. If you haven't made a decision to go yet, it's not too late. You can register. I don't think Early Bird has closed. Early Bird has closed? Okay.
They extended it
for a bit, and then those who have only just heard about their abstracts have got an extension. That's morally the correct thing to do. In hindsight, I stuffed up the timelines a little bit in that I forgot about Easter and the school holidays and stuff, but we've got through that.
It's detailed.
It's a detail, exactly.
You just haven't been around that line, has it?
Yeah. So the next challenge for us, for me and Roger, is to work out the room scheduling. For example, there are the Melbourne Convention Centre has more than enough capacity in terms of numbers to take the people, but if everybody wanted to have a keynote lecture at the same time in a big hall, we don't have enough big halls, so we've got to try to sort that out now. We've asked for if you're involved in any of the program organisation committees. I've taken a very different approach to the last Congress in Adelaide in 2014. I'm not doing a top-down command and control approach. I'm doing a bottom-up, tell us what you want approach, and I'll endeavour to give everyone what they want. I can't guarantee it. If the 15 talks all want to use the plenary hall at the same time, well, I'm going to have to make some decisions. But I'm confident we can get there. I might have to fly to Melbourne and spend a day or two with Roger just sorting out the algorithm there, but it's looking good. There's a healthy social program to... Can you go to... Simon, can you drive the... Is there a social thing there? There's a social thing somewhere on the website. For those who are interested, I think it's under program.
Pro-registration.
Registration, that might be... There we are, social functions, yeah. There's a bunch of social stuff that you can do there, including for those who... don't know Melbourne all that well, you can go and hug a koala or go down the Great Ocean Road or go to the Yarra Valley and drink some wines. I'm personally disappointed. The Saturday night before the Congress starts on the Sunday afternoon, the Victorian branch had agreed, just some arm twisting, to host a centenary ball. That is not going ahead. I confirm that today for two reasons. Reason number one is that registration numbers were too low to make it economically viable, but element number two is a ball, black tie ball. 90% of those who registered, including myself, are male, and I said to Roger Stapleford, I might enjoy working with you, buddy, but I'm going to refuse, I'm going to dance with you. He said, feelings mutual. So there was a demographic problem as much as anything else. Because we're going to a conference, you generally don't take your partner, and so that was going to be an issue. So I'm a little bit disappointed about that, but there's still a variety of dinners going on every night of the week. There's poster sessions going on all through the Congress. We've got to make a decision. The posters will be held in what's called the Melbourne Room. It's a very large flat space, and depending upon how we finally see the numbers panning out, we might halve the Melbourne Room for posters and use the other half as a flat space for talks, or we might keep the posters up the whole time. The advantage of chopping it in half is we get another relatively large space for talks. The advantage of not doing that is we'll be able to keep posters up for a longer period of time so that people can view them. That's all got to get sorted out. Yet these are the sort of decisions that can only be made once we know delegate numbers and so on and so forth. So it's getting down to the pointy end. Before I invite anyone to ask me any questions about how everything is going, I'll just point out that the final sign of my confidence and optimism that everything is working fine, this Congress is being held in the last week of July. For the first 3 weeks of July, I'm going on holiday, and I'm driving into the outback on my four-wheel drive where there is no internet, no mobile phone coverage, no nothing. I'm driving from Perth to Ayers Rock, and I'll be completely incommunicado, but I'm so confident that everything is going well that won't be a problem. And I didn't really give Roger Stapleford much of a choice on that anyway. So seriously, I'm quite confident and excited that this is already going to be the biggest event, meeting type event that the ROCI has ever run, to celebrate our first 100 years, and it'll be a launchpad for our next 100 years. Any questions? Keep looking.